Hello everybody, welcome to Paignton Station here in Devon. Today we're going to be trying out one of GWR's Class 150 Sprinter units. We're going to be taking it all the way along the Exmouth branch. It's about an hour and a bit journey. So I've got my tickets booked, let's crack on and go and see the station. Here at Paignton, as you can see, we have a nice self-service ticket machine. I haven't had to use this one, so I don't know if it works. We've got information boards. As you can see, we've got train times. Tickets office through here by the looks of things. We do have what looks like an old whistle stop cafe in here, which it seems to be going to redevelopment. We have ticket office over there too. So if we come through here, we can see there is a Voyager on the platform. This is not our service. We will be taking the 1024 Great Western Railway service, but this is obviously cross country. Here comes our train now. Today our train will be formed of two BR Class 150 Sprinter units.
Platform 2 for the 1024 Great Western Railway service to Exmouth. Calling at Torquay, Tor, Newton Abbott, Tynmouth, Dawlish, Marsh Barton, Exeter St David's, Exeter Central, St James Park, Polslow Bridge, Digby and Salton, Newcourt, Topsham, Exton, Lipstone Commando, Lipstone Village and Exmouth. This train has Borken. Exton and Lipstone Commando are request stops.
266 and 246.
Staff conductor on the train will arrange for the train to stop to allow them to leave. Platform 2 for the 1024 Great Western Railway service to Exmouth.
On board. As you can see, seating on this train is laid out in a 2 plus 2 configuration. I'm going to take this set of two seats here, as you can see. First impressions are that, as you can see, there is on some of these seats, which isn't great for a train which was refurbished not too long ago. Here we are in the seat, I'm doing a bit of the seat top. So I'm 6'2" for reference, and as you can see, legroom is pretty tight. Even by regional train standards, I've certainly seen better on the likes of the 172s. We have, as you can see, got a power socket and two USBs right by the window. And there goes my charger. So that's there, that seems to be working all right. On the seat front, we have the seat back table. This is pretty small. It looks relatively clean, apart from that. We've also got an adjustable armrest in between seats. It's pretty good, I'll be having that down in a bit. As you can see, we're also in GWR scheme, which is quite soft to be fair. It's quite well padded, better than I was expecting. Yeah, that's pretty comfortable. I've certainly seen worse. So we've got two USBs, we've got that there. We have got ventilation in the form of these hopper windows, because aircon wasn't a thing, can't open them. Well, not with that, I still get those open in a bit. We've got, as I say, the seat back. Quite decent window alignment, though you will notice it is pretty dirty, so maybe they could do having a bit of a clean. We have overhead luggage racks as well, which are pretty dirty, pretty skanky, but the lighting inside, as you can see, is nice and subtle. That's a really nice addition. And something that you might want to bear in mind is some of these seats have got this metal equipment underneath them, which does inhibit legroom slightly, but just provide a bit of a nice footrest, I guess.
Well, I'm on the next one, but it's
quiet, I've just swapped seats to the other side so I can get some of the sea views. As you can see, the legroom here is significantly better. As I said, I'm 6'2" and there's plenty of space here. And there's some views out the window. Five 101, which is the other unit on the Exmouth shuttle today. As you can see, these windows are incredibly dirty, so you can't really get a great view out of them, which is definitely something GWR need to look into. very, very much in the middle of nowhere. This is single track. Exmouth after our short journey on a GWR Class 150. So what do I think of this train? I think it is a fantastic little unit for these little backwater branch lines. I wouldn't want to ride on one on a main intercity service. That said, I still do think they are absolutely fine for what they're used for. So thank you for watching today's video. As always, if you have enjoyed, don't forget to leave a like, comment down below, share and subscribe, and I'll see you very soon. Until then, bye for now.